quality of life is very dependent on surgeons and their ability to restore function, to live an active life. And as people live longer, that's becoming an increasing desire. But current technologies fall short with a one-size-fits-all solution. Restore 3D's vision is to repair and reconstruct the human body. We are truly pushing the edge on patient-specific personalized solutions, advanced manufacturing with regards to 3D printing. Restore 3D has a range of printing technologies. We have metal printers that are printing cobalt chrome and titanium alloys for most of our implants. Polymer printers are used from everything from prototyping to end-use devices. Things like these instrumentations, such as trials and inserters, anatomical models that allow surgeons to understand the preoperative and postoperative outcomes they're looking to achieve. Formlabs is something we use for most of our disposable instruments, both for our sterile packed instruments that come for our various applications, such as our osteotomy wedges. We also use them for our patient-specific custom devices that are made on a one-off basis, cutting guides, inserters.
What we do in orthopedic oncology is inherently creative because, unlike normal orthopedic operations where you're doing a surgery to match existing implants, think about a hip or a knee replacement, we're doing surgeries to remove cancer from the body, and we often don't know in advance exactly what we're going to need.
In most of our cases, we'll provide between 1 and 3 metal implants, and we'll probably provide between 6 and 8 Formlabs components that come with the metal instruments. So the Formlabs instruments are really central to the completion of the case and most of what we're doing.
One thing I've noticed since I've been working with Restore 3D is that I use our intraoperative navigation system much less. And the reason for that is how good the cutting guides are. Computer navigation in surgery is great. It's fascinating to see, medical students love it, but it does add a lot of time to the case. It adds a lot of radiation to the patient. And when we can accomplish the same thing with well-engineered cutting guides, it's good for everyone. Historically, cutting guides are meant for saws, and you're making these hard, geometric, rectangular cuts. By making things where we have round cuts or where we capture other things like a router or a reamer, we can often get away with less exposure and less dissection to make some very precise geometric cuts.
The thing that we really like about using Formlabs printers is the flexibility that they provide us on the design end. We've worked with different printers and different applications, and often there are certain features that we find to be out of bounds due to specific print orientations, due to support material, particular cures that we have to use. When it comes to making any request that a surgeon has, we're almost always able to provide that in a Formlabs material. The reason that we like Formlabs resin is its intraoperative characteristics. It's tough. It allows us to really kind of print what we want without too much concern about material thinning or breaking. Things like impactors, cutting tools, drilling guides. If we can't provide something in metal, odds are that we're able to provide it in resin and get the function that we need.
The single biggest benefit for surgeons is the ability to treat their patients on a unique, personalized way. 3D printing, it allows us to iterate very quickly and take surgeons' feedback and deliver a new solution relatively quickly.
Patient-specific implants, I think, have a really large future in medical device when you think about the next 5 years. A lot of surgeons come to us with their first case, which is a really challenging case, and then that experience they want to use more and more because 3D printing made their OR experience easier. As 3D printing technologies continue to improve, you're going to see that become more and more pervasive over time.
The world is changing all the time, and nothing's changing quicker than medicine and biotechnology. It's actually very fun and very rewarding and very good for your patients to keep up with these kinds of developments.